well. We encourage you to sing in your minds and in your hearts. Thank you for your cooperation. Today in our liturgy, we celebrate the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider this afternoon is Father Peter Ratcha, and our deacon is Robert Sturm. Please stand.
Amen. reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines. Juicy, rich food and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all people, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth. For the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we looked to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us, for the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thank you, God.
The responsorial psalm, "I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life." You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. I shall live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said, "Guiding you." of the people. In parables saying, the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fattened cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come on the feast. Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, the feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worth to come. Go out therefore into the main roads and invite to the feast whomever you find. The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Beloved sisters and brothers in Christ, this is how the husband explained the situation to his newly married wife. Honey, you know what? Unfortunately, you will not be able to afford for a restaurant, so you will have to cook every day. Oh, it's not a problem for me, honey, wife replies. I'm just worried that you will have to eat all that stuff. How many times in our marital situations expectations missed out on reality? We could see it very well during the coronavirus lockdown, when an excess of free time suddenly appeared. It turned out that wives had a completely different idea how their husbands should spend it, and vice versa. A to-do list postponed for a long time found their chance to be shortened, but the problem of communication appeared. The same seems to be true for the parable of the wedding feast. The king's expectations of celebrating his son's wedding and sharing his joy do not match his subject's priorities. In such situations, tension arises and aggression escalates, as it had happened. Situations of making offers that is persuading on the one hand and consenting or refusing on the other are the bread and butter of our human relationships. We deal with it well until our priorities and beliefs, what is good for ourselves and others, are threatened. If we feel such a threat, we are capable of aggression. The greater, the more threatened the good we identify ourselves with is. That is why the first feast doesn't take place, because apart from the unworthy guests, we are dealing with a false image of God and a cult of idol, rather, in which the motive of fear and aggression is dominant. As long as the love we want to cultivate is based on this pattern, whose truth is greater or whose good is more important, we will be in a never-ending war, because this is the idol we worship. In this pattern, the argument that the wife is not cooking tasty enough and the husband is a miser obsessed with money is inevitable. This idol will destroy our relationships and will drive us into solitude. In the second scheme, where there is no competition for domination, it is possible to gather the participants of the celebration together. Here, the invitees were more effective, and those invited came both good and bad. The only criterion was the mysterious rope, without which it was impossible to stay at the feast. It is a garment that allows me to be with others because it balances my egocentrism, compensates my selfishness. When I put it on, I will try to cheer my wife, who may not be a very skilled cook yet. When I put it on, I will be grateful to my husband for another item from to-do list, which disappeared. When I put it on, I will be able to notice that Shogat forsakes me and is letting me enter into a closer relationship with him. The relationship of being chosen to God's childhood, because this is what the wedding of the Son means. When I come to that reflection, the Son will show me how to motivate myself and others to do good. Only this way I can be vested in the right way for eternal life. Amen.
And now, brothers and sisters, let us profess together our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, shrine from shrine, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Let us raise our prayers up to God, whom we trust to fully supply whatever we need.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For our churches, pastors, ministers, and teachers, that they may lead us and all peoples of God's holy mountain. We pray, Lord, hear our prayer. For legislators, courts, and agencies of government, that they may work to provide all peoples with a just share of the world's harvest, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For men and women suffering after abortion, that the church's healing ministry may help them find peace through Christ and His mercy, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus, knowledge that the Spirit will give healing to those who are ill and inspiration to those working on a vaccine, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick from injury or illness, and for those who are homebound, that they may experience God's healing and comfort, especially for Jack Kaczewski, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they may be invited into the heavenly kingdom, especially for Loretta Liveris and Joseph Tortorello, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their intention being offered at this Mass for Ronald Kalish, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers that we make in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, thank you for welcoming us to your banquet and grant what we needed the most to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Given that name, wrote and gave it to
my body, which will be given up for you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving a thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
body.
Struggling people around the world. Please be generous in next week's collection to support. support the propagation of the faith. Weekly scripture reflections have returned, and they are available through a live Zoom meeting. Please see the bulletin for details. The Knights of Columbus are asking for donations to help support our SPREAD program at St. Zachary and the Mentally Challenged of Des Plaines. See the bulletin for information. Please visit the school parish websites for other information.
And before the final blessing, I once again would like to thank you for continuous supporting St. Zachary Parish. Your contribution makes our mission possible. If you would like to contribute to St. Zachary, there are many ways. You can leave your envelope here in the church, you can mail it to us, or you can give it to us by online. Thank you so much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mercy and go in peace.
Thank you, God.